Dear learners, welcome to the module. The module is based on technology in distance education, which includes open educational resources, Creative Commons licensing, Moodle LMS, MOOC, and SWAYAM. We have already discussed about OER and the CC licensing system in the previous videos. In this video, we will discuss about MOOC, Moodle LMS, and SWAYAM. MOOC. MOOC stands for Massive Open Online Course. MOOCs are widely regarded as a tool to boost higher education. There are a number of reasons for the popularity of MOOCs. They are designed to accommodate a large number of participants. The MOOCs are often free and there are no entry qualifications. Since the courses are online, they can be accessed from anywhere and anytime. OER can be used as a study material. This will make the cost of learning almost negligible. MOOCs are considered vital tools in education by the governments of developing countries, because these courses can educate the uneducated masses. But it is also one of the criticisms of MOOC that it hasn't been much helpful to its target learners, who are the uneducated masses. While it has been helpful to the well-learned learners, nevertheless, MOOCs remain a legitimate tool to solve problems in higher education with the help of technological innovations. Let's now look at a few benefits and limitations of MOOCs. If we look at the benefits, MOOCs can help the wider participation in higher education by helping learners with easy access and cost-effective learning. MOOCs can play a role in bridging the gap between people who have had access to formal education and those who couldn't afford it. MOOCs can help the return of investment in education. Quality education can contribute significantly to the development of the society, politically, economically, and culturally. As mentioned earlier, cost-effective learning is an advantage of MOOCs. When we look at the limitations of MOOC, we will find that MOOCs have not yet been able to find a place for itself in the conventional education system. There are no comprehensive policies that support its incorporation into the conventional system. This is a challenge to the authenticity of MOOCs. Secondly, one cannot still say that the society has benefited largely from MOOCs because it is just starting to make its presence felt. MOOCs may also find it difficult to remove some pre-existing barriers among its learners. These barriers can be anything from economic differences to something as simple as the availability of network connectivity. Now we shall discuss about Moodle LMS, where LMS stands for Learning Management System. Moodle is one of the most used learning management systems around the world because it is capable to deliver to the demands of almost all kinds of organizations in countries around the world. It is a safe, flexible, and open platform that is constantly updated as per the user's need. Moodle helps in creating compelling visualizations, which include charts, tables, etc. It creates an effective learning environment by keeping the students engaged and interested. Moodle puts up diverse teaching methods that include text, audio, video, PowerPoint slides, etc. It also has a built-in grading process called Gradebook. Moodle promotes open online communication and collaboration between its learners through chat rooms, comment, blog post, etc. Since Moodle is open source, it can be extremely helpful for the non-profit organizations in global digital distribution. Thus, Moodle can play a great role to improve the state of higher education. SWAYAM. Now we shall move ahead to discuss about SWAYAM. SWAYAM stands for Study Webs of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. It is a program initiated by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. AICTE and MHRD developed SWAYAM with the assistance of Microsoft. This platform helps centrally funded universities to provide online courses, and it has made India one of the few countries in the world to have their own online platform with study material, lectures, assignments, etc. that can be used to secure credit in the public assessment system. SWAYAM provides both curriculum-based and skill-based courses across different disciplines in higher education. All these courses are certified by respective authorities. SWAYAM promotes a unified scheme of certification across different streams in higher education. This helps the learners to find a common ground. The content and course developed are analyzed and certified by experts. SWAYAM is thus able to dispel many criticisms of the MOOCs, especially the lack of a unified certification scheme. This brings us to the end of this module, Technology in Distance Education. Here is a list of references and further readings. Do visit these articles for a better understanding of the concepts that we have discussed briefly. Thank you for watching the video. Do watch the other videos on different modules of the course. Good luck.